Hello everybody, welcome back to another video. Today we are playing a game. Now this is a game that shouldn't really be fun. I mean, it's not a joke. It's not like, it's a serious game that we should take seriously. This is a game, here let me quickly check what exactly, because this is a autobiography. I know for a fact. Right here. It's a game created by Ryan and Amy Green, Josh Larson, and a small team under the name of Numinous Games. It's an autobiography based on the Greens. Oh, so it's made by the parents. I'm guessing. That's what I'm guessing. I don't know. Because Green. Experience of raising their son Joel, who is diagnosed with terminal cancer at 12 years old. Or 12 months old. So, this is a. It's not really. Yeah. You guys get it. So, we're gonna hop into it. Yeah. Bread on the water. Beautiful. One second. There we go. Sorry, the noise was very loud. It's beautiful, like scenery and animation. Aw, the duck. Am I the duck? And apparently the recordings are real. Like, the voices and things are like the actual voices of the family.
Oh, don't touch the birds. No. Don't touch the birds. No, gross. Yuck.
This is a really nice game. I'm a goose. I'm a geese-esses. I'm a goose-esses.
Did you see that one almost bit him?
Oh, guys, give Joel some bread. Mom, who's who let that piece?
Well, Isaac, you gotta give him little pieces. He doesn't understand. Here you go, Joel. Here's a piece. Okay, no, you throw it.
Joel's almost five, right?
Yeah.
Mom, but he can't talk.
It's true.
Yeah.
You always can talk.
Yeah, I know.
Why can't Joel?
Well, he got sick right after he turned one.
Kind of slowed him down a little bit, buddy.
So he's just slower than most kids. I think eventually he'll get to it.
Okay, so basically, he got it at a year old. He got cancer at a year old, and it looks like this is about. This is about, after he was diagnosed 2 years
He's
later.
supposed to be a boy, but he's a baby. He's a boy baby.
Yep, he's a boy baby. That's just about right. You know, there's lots of things Joel isn't good at, but there's some things he is good at. What is he good at?
Eating, laughing.
Yeah.
I'm good at making him laugh.
You are good at making him laugh. Well, how do you make him laugh?
I fall down.
Yeah. It's really funny when you fall down.
He's good at doing this what he loves.
Yeah.
That's cool. The words follow the screen. This is a really cool game. Park at the Edge of the World. This is almost like Untitled
Ooh,
Goose Game,
that's
like
Dola.
animation, or like
Wawa. In
texture.
cups, bathtubs. In the warm, wet tongues and the cool fur of Das. Give me the sweet mwahs of daily affection. And bye-byes.
and long kisses. And more.
Oh.
Always more. This full list of words. So few.
This is so cool. I can't imagine what it must have been like. This is that.
No one ever realizes how short the time is.
Who's that? Are they like spirits? The sounds of the
Who's
birds are really beautiful.
That word? What is hope? Without a word for it. Who is God? What is joy? Who am I to him?
Let's tell him, Kayla, that Joel's doing really well. Yeah. He's been very peaceful all afternoon.
Oh, am I going down now? Oh, I'm the, am I the kid?
Thank you.
Oh, I'm on it with the kid? Okay. This is a very, like, I don't know how to explain it. It's almost peaceful, but at the same time, you know why it's peaceful. Is that a dragon? Why is there a helicopter? Those
fear is cancer's preservative, cancer's embalming oil. And you, O accuser, are fear's oil sales. You're a snake, a serpent, a dragon with snuffed out coal on his breath, molting, talons broken from the struggle to free yourself of your own skin.
That dragon, cancer. On hospital time.
Hey, do you want to rock? Okay, let's rock. There we go.
I was just thinking, do you ever think maybe Joel can hear better than he's supposed to be able to? Because I know, like, it's supposed to be moderate to severe hearing loss, but sometimes, like today, he hears music playing before I do. So I saw him dancing, and I had to look around to hear that a song was playing. And I just don't, like, if his hearing loss is that bad, I can't imagine. I don't know. I just wonder about it. Anyway, call me later. Bye.
He has to keep pressing it before it runs out. Oh, they're glove balloons. asleep. Flying on balloons. Oh, I'm controlling him with my mouse. That's so cool. Oh. Uh-oh. Don't crash into those. I don't think those are good. Are those like the blobs of cancer? Come on. Doing okay. So I feel like this is him, like, battling the cancer. Oh shoot. Oh, one of my balloons popped. Don't die. Come on. Perfect. Oh, I just made it. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Oh no. I think eventually this is supposed to be impossible. I'm dead. Or, it's... Don't... Okay. Stay there. Nice. Oh, is it just a dream? Oh, it's just a dream.
Oh, hey. Oh. I just wanted to take a shower. Is that okay? Are you okay with Joel? Okay, thanks.
Am I his wife? Now? Oh! Oh, there he is. He's knocking. Seems like such a happy child. So sad that the parents had to go through this. End of treatment party. Why is it changing? Like the lighting, that has to be for a reason. Oh, are these all the pictures? Wait. Claire's first. Untitled. Henry and Ella Oliver. Peggy's Cove. you, Linda, who made the largest impression? Galactic Treasure by L. Williams and Jones. Ja. Untitled. There is Phoenix Rising Oil on Canvas. Is there a phone ringing that I'm supposed to pick up? Never mind. Do I go in there? Oh yeah, I do. Voicemail. Why am I not listening to the voicemail?
Hey, I'm cleaning up eggs again.
That's scary.
A dozen eggs on the kitchen floor again. So we have to get a new lock for the fridge. It's so hard to clean up eggs from the floor. Like, they just spread around and they don't come clean no matter what you do. So I'm just so frustrated, but you should have seen them together. They were so proud of themselves. Joel and Elijah just sitting there with their eggs. Isaac said he thinks they want to be cookers. All right. Talk to you soon. Bye.
Yeah, I remember when Alec, when my little cousin Alec lived here, he would always get into the fridge. It was horrible. He had eggs on the floor, and it was difficult to clean up. They spread so much. But that was amazing. Their phone. I need to charge my phone.
Hey, honey, we're on our way home from the hospital now. So if you wanted to preheat the oven starting in about 30 minutes, that would work, and we could throw in that lasagna. Do you know how they celebrate off treatment day, like when kids are done with their treatments? I guess maybe you don't because you're not in the clinic as much as I am, but on someone's last day, they always bring them a cake and they sing happy off therapy day to you. Anyway, that happened today. I mean, it happens a lot, but today I cried. I just wanted that day so bad, you know? I just, like, we're not ever going to get that day. If he's better, we won't know that he's better. We don't get a day. Anyway, okay, call me if you can. Like, there's probably traffic, so I could talk on my way home.
Alright, bye. Oh, I get to share this with you, okay. Oh, this is so cool. This is like a... Oh, I can hit those. This is so cool. Oh shoot, I just went out of control. Oh, 2011. Oh. Is that the year? Oh. Those are all the treatments.
Well, how long is it going to be before we can have some answers? Did anyone ask the doctor?
Okay, is it just the doctor on call or is this our doctor? Well, because the on-call doctor is just a resident.
Is there a way we can talk to our doctor?
hall there anymore. The Temple of Man. Oh, is this an MRI scan?
I love you, my friend. This is my favorite name, Jesse. Watch out, start it. Tearsaws is my favorite. This is a really cute game. Was that awful? Sorry, I thought I heard yelling. Oh, that might have just been the speaker, or in my headphone.
This terrible routine, watching you. waiting for you to wake, hoping you will never remember these days of illness and treatment. One day, I'll bring you here, show you your tiny handprints on the wall, and you'll be annoyed that we all think of you as some big miracle. Cancer will be such a small part of all you could grow to be. You will tire of hearing about it. You won't want to see the cards and notes I saved. And I won't mind at all. I'll hold the memories of this hard day. You just leave it behind.
Elise, we love you dearly and miss you daily. See you soon. Or Elsie. But have no fear, our story's just begun. Hugs to all my UIHC kids and families. Greg Rice. Matthews Dow. Born December 3rd, 1998. Wait, what? Oh, 12th of March, 1998, and then 18th of May, 2008, died May, oh. To everyone who's died of cancer, especially my father and grandmother, rest in peace, Hank, Marcia, and all the rest of you, beautiful, beautiful people. I hope that whatever has become of you, you are presently better off than you were at the end of your life. We miss you. Take my tears, love, they will carry you home. These are all cards. All of them. They put them all into the game. Joshua, stay strong, little man. Mommy and Daddy love you. This is really sad. In loving memory of Jan and Don Hubbard. Doyle Redden, a name that means a lot to me. A loving wife, a mother, my grandmother, and a cancer survivor. Hardly a woman of grace, but a person of great strength. I'm glad you can continue your fight should it ever arise again. I love you, Grandma. You went in your sleep after months in pain. Miss you, Grandma. For my brother Kyle. Antonio Martinelli, your grandson is terribly sorry and misses you so much. To Lily and Ethan, I never knew love until you were both born, holding you in my arms. That first night I knew my world had changed forever. For forever. I'll always love you and be with you. Love, Dad. Jared Goring, your family misses you so much. I miss you, Mom. To say we miss you is an understatement. Love you, Mom. DBL. I shall cover you with my hand until I have passed. I'll read a few while going up. Sadly, I can't read all of them. I'll come back here after the video and read more, because these are... Thanks for being my Uncle Aaron. Bippo. Madison Elizabeth Beimer, 4302 to 82109. Brayden and Beck and my whole heart. Love, Daddy. Viola Oak, Ike, Mama Oak, Papa Alscar. Could be different language, I don't know. Happiness comes from loving what you do. True, that is very true. I think this will be my last. I won so far, but still fighting. Where did all these letters come from, I wonder? Who put them here? Or put them, like, where did they find them? I'm sorry, guys, it's not good. I used to have one of these. Not obviously not the exact same one, but you know. The ducks always win.
Farmer Bill scratches the pig's chinny chin chin.
Oh, the sun is getting closer to the dark sky. I didn't realize that.
Those mischievous pigs are napping on Farmer Bill's couch.
I think this is the last one.
The pigs wash the dishes after supper.
Oh, I think I know what it means now. Or what it means.
I'm sorry, guys. It's not good.
Size matters. If I know how big it is, I can face it. I can size it up.
And it's quite small at this point, but unfortunately the size isn't terribly important. Any recurrence means the chemotherapy has failed. This is a tragedy.
Sob uncontrollably or puke just right on the floor. I thought I'd shake or wail or something. I guess this is shock. Tragedy, he said. That's right. That's the perfect word for this. It's a tragedy. I wonder if he says that every time. He's crying a little. I love him for that. He's not callous, he's genuinely sad. She is too.
So there just aren't any treatment options that are curative.
We're very good at end-of-life care. very good at managing the pain and masking symptoms at the end of life. How long are we talking about?
Prediction time again. No matter what I say, they'll wish it was longer. But sometimes longer is worse. A few weeks to maybe 4 months.
Is Nick crying?
How long are we talking about?
How am I gonna hold it together now?
A few weeks to maybe 4 months.
Oh wait, was I supposed to?
I cannot crash. They shouldn't feel like they have to come
for
me.
Palliative?
Palliative is medicine you give at the end of life to improve the quality of life. Its goal is to treat the symptoms, but it can't cure Joel.
We'll do a lumbar puncture and talk to our radiation oncologist to decide whether we could do some radiation or just chemotherapy.
What would the radiation do?
Well, the radiation could probably kill the tumor we see now, which would prevent it from causing any symptoms. But it would not keep more tumors from developing. Because we know if it's spread here, it has spread other places too.
So, the radiation would buy us some time?
No, nothing will really buy us any time at this point. It just can make the time you have left more comfortable. So, we'll schedule you to come back in Monday. And we'll have some options for you to consider. We're so sorry.
In the movie, I'd be kicking things and throwing chairs through windows. Amy would be sobbing and back against the wall, slowly falling. I should be yelling. Why am I not yelling?
Adrift. Am I a duck again? I'm sorry, it's really late right now. I got off work.
I have so many things stirring around in my spirit that I have to write to settle myself and find God's wisdom in the midst of chaos.
I'm scared I won't be strong enough to face the things we might have to face in the coming weeks and months. But then, I remember how much grace God gave us to walk out everything we've already faced. I've never felt completely overwhelmed, and I've never felt alone. So no matter what comes next, and I truly cannot even begin to guess how this will go, I know we will be carried. What? To shout out, look what God is about to do. Watch how he delivers Joel. And at the same time, I'm gonna roll up in a silent ball and wait it out with fear and trembling, so aware of all my doubt, but yet convinced that my doubt is insignificant compared to God's faithfulness.
As you ready for bed?
Joel, lay down.
Check in his mouth?
Joel, no.
Joel has chicken stuffed in his cheeks from dinner.
That is so disgusting.
Been in there for the last 2 hours. Okay, hold on, I'm trying. Joel, ouch! Stop.
Did he just bite you?
I think he like just put too much in his mouth so he can't swallow.
He was just saving it for later, babe. Like he needed a midnight snack.
Oh
my goodness. Okay.
A big version
of a little chipmunk. Do you guys remember when he couldn't even eat any solids and he couldn't swallow? Do you remember that from the surgery? How it hurt his ability to swallow, so we had to give him bottles?
Yeah, I remember one time we had pizza, so he chewed it all up and then spat it out everywhere.
So gross.
But he just wanted to try things so bad. He wanted to taste them. He wanted to be like you guys. Because he got to taste foods. He loved to eat, and I remember all I wanted was for him to be able to kind of eat like a normal kid and have normal things. I thought he'd never be able to swallow normal food. But then he did.
And now he's everything.
Everything. Like he eats pizza and pretzels and chicken.
And fingers.
He tried food. He's going to eat his dad's fingers.
Ouch!
Okay.
And penguins.
Okay. Settle down. Come here. Let's sing a song. Okay. What should we sing, Isaac?
When you will.
Okay.
Cause I like it.
Yeah. Hey. You guys would love to have fun with you.
I'm trying to get the little
story. But at bedtime. Elijah, lay down. When you guys get real sleep, then they try to get silly too. So instead, will we be calming? Will you kind of just help me sing to them?
Yeah, sure.
Okay. When the sun is setting, we know. Lay that down. Sun, we laughed and played together, and we've had so much fun. Now close your eyes.
Oh, I didn't know I was able to move. Sorry, guys.
Helping Joel, then we want to stay and do the best we can for him and stay there where he's getting help.
attention is so maddening sometimes. Do you know what she wrote on the eve of Joel's first surgery? The one back in January when we first found the tumor? I seriously feel like a kid on Christmas Eve. I'm pleading for God to spare his life, and I'm tempted to despair because self-inspection leads me to conclude I shouldn't expect much of anything. And yet my wife is expecting a surprise party from the Lord, replete with presents, supernatural miracles. I envy her.
Joel, the baby knight.
Hop in bed, boys. Let's go.
Boys, get in bed.
Oh, can you at least tell us a story?
That dragon cancer.
Sure.
Okay. This is the story of a very brave knight named
Joel.
Joel the baby knight?
Yes, Joel the baby knight, but he's also Joel the very brave knight, and he was being chased by a dragon named Cancer.
Oh, this is so cool.
Where does the dragon live?
In a forest.
Is the dragon big?
Very.
Does the dragon breathe fire?
What?
Too much fire, you guys.
I thought I crouched, but okay.
So, Joel has armor, like a sword and a shield and stuff? Ooh, or maybe a spear?
Yeah, that sounds good. So brave Sir Joel, with his sword and his shield and his awesome spear and...
How do I... What?
Super jumping ability was being chased by a dragon.
Okay, now I have super jumping ability.
What other superpowers does he have?
He also has grace.
That's not a superpower.
It's the best superpower.
Do you guys know what grace means?
Yeah, it's kind of like help.
Yeah, it's kind of like help.
Got it. There we go.
You know, and he's not the only one who's ever tried to fight this dragon. Some very brave knights have fought this dragon and lost. And some are able to drive the dragon off. And then they can go home and they can quit fighting for a while. In the kingdom and the city.
Joel's been fighting this dragon for a long time, huh?
A long time.
But Joel found a nice empty cave where he could rest. And it seems like the dragon couldn't find him. But just when he thought that the danger was past, the dragon found his hiding spot and came after him in the cave.
That dragon's going to kill Joel. Joel's going to lose.
Why do you say that?
Because Joel is just a baby. Babies can't kill dragons.
You're right. A baby can't kill a dragon.
I lost all my armor.
That's the best part of this story. God fights for Joel. So he fights that dragon cancer right with Joel. And we know that God can win.
Oh, shoot.
That's grace.
Shoot.
Well, what about Tim from Church Mom? He died from cancer. Wasn't God fighting for him? Didn't he have grace?
Of course.
dragon. Found the spot where the dragon can't hit me. Nope. Come on, I have 2 hearts left. Drowning. Sky is beautiful.
Ryan! Oh, Ryan, get in the boat.
I can't.
You have to, you'll drown.
We're already drowning. How can you sit there like that?
Despair doesn't help anything.
Neither does false hope. And I'm not despairing.
How can you say false hope? You're drowning!
Well, you're missing your oars! And you don't even know where you're going. And yet you're so sure you're gonna get there.
It's better than drowning.
Well, enjoy floating on the surface like you always do.
There's nothing deep about drowning. Just get in the boat.
You have to let me feel this. Someone has to.
That's not fair. I love him as much as you do. I just really believe we're going to be okay.
We miss Carrie at week 12. Sad, sad. But surely the next one will go better. It does. We relax after week 12. The belly grows. We take pictures. Alex talks and plays music to the little one inside. I walk on the frozen North Sea. Skip the sauna. No risk to this one. Week 29, a sonogram bonus. Twins! We float on air, we brainstorm names. Week 31, we crash. Too soon, too soon. They whimper, open eyes, look into ours. Off to the incubators. We drag ourselves home, cry, hope, pray. We visit, touch, keep track on a wall chart. Stefan's heart beats strong. He grasps a finger. Then he fades, his brain bruised from breech birth. Day 5, he dies. We grieve, but pray for Nicholas. He gains weight, his heart is strong. Then he too fades, his intestinal tract necrotic, falling apart. Day 10, Nicholas dies. We want to die too. We despair into darkness, but hold together, not easy when a child dies. The what ifs torment for a while. What if I hadn't swum? If I hadn't lifted groceries? If we'd had a different doctor? But we go on to have 3 wonderful living children. Still, we miss these two always.
Dear Mr. Barnett, I'm not sure if this letter will get to you. However, I felt the need to write to you in your company. My daughter recently passed away after a long battle with cancer, and she was only 14 years old. In our short time with her, we saw her transformed from our wonderful little girl into a sickly child who spent far too many days in her bed, full of pain. And we worried that we would never see her happy again. Well, the hospital gave her access to a computer, and she found her way to your game. I'm unsure really what it is, but from the day that she began playing Legends of Terrace, our daughter changed. She sat up, she was excited, she smiled again. She told us all these stories about what she was doing in the lands, all the things she wanted to do in real life, but was too sick to try. She swam in the ocean, rode a horse, she had birthdays, bought a house, and she went on adventures with these new friends from all over the world. I don't know how to explain the happiness that it brought to us. For a short while, our daughter returned to us. She'd regained the wonder and an optimism that the illness had taken from her. She talked about strange lands that you had made, the creatures, magical things, and adventures she went on. She lost her battle for life, but you helped bring our daughter back for a short time. And for that, we're eternally thankful. Sincerely.
Many things stirring around in my spirit that I have to write to settle myself and find God's wisdom in the midst of chaos. I'm scared I won't be strong enough to face the things we might have to face in the coming weeks and months. But then I remember how much grace God gave us to walk out everything we've already faced. I've never felt completely overwhelmed, and I've never felt alone. So no matter what comes next, and I truly cannot even begin to guess how this will go.
Sure, I'm supposed to go now. I think I just
thank you.
swim to the surface to pretend that everything's gonna be okay, but he can't because the despair is just keeping him down. And he can't just be happy. Dehydration.
Huh. The sunset looks pretty from here. The orange glow cast on the wall. Better than the muted colors of this hospital. I wonder why they choose blues and greens. They, the ones who choose the colors that heal. Green for life. Blue. For comfort. Purple stripes to hide the stains. This chair is too small and sticks to my skin. Blue, purple. The ocean, maybe? Now, under the ocean. Silent, warm, and salty, like tears.
There's the arcade machine.
He won't stop crying. I don't blame him. He feels miserable. I hate that we're here. I hate that he's sick. I just want to feel better. Here we go, bouncing around. Do you like that? Oh, I love your giggle. Bounce around. Is that funny? A bounce, a bounce, a bounce, bounce, bounce. Oh, he won't stop crying. He's hungry. Don't you want juice? He hits the box. I don't catch it. He drinks it greedily. Big, deep gulps. Okay, Jolie, that's enough. Breathe, kiddo. And he does, and I wipe his face of snot, and tears, and juice. And then he vomits, and I catch it. I always catch it.
but you'll throw it up. No, don't grab too hard. You'll squirt all the juice out. Here, let me have it. It's so late, Joel. Lay down. I can't hold you. I can't make you feel better. Okay, buddy, okay, I'll hold you. Oh, Joel Bug, you look so miserable. No! Don't hit your head on the bars, Joel. Joel, Joel, I know you're mad. Please stop. Please. Stop. I shake, I weep, I pray, I plead, I need peace. I am empty. You are. Oh, no, you are. You are there. I want you here. I want you to call my son. Not. And you've brought us this far. He's still here, not dead, not there, with you. Oh God, I want him here with me. Please. Sleeps. Thank you.
Peace be still.
There's a story in the Bible where Jesus and his disciples are on a boat. And a furious storm hits the sea, and everyone thinks they're gonna die. Where do you think Jesus is? Rowing alongside them? No. He's asleep. In the back of the boat. So his disciples are freaking out and wake him up, and they say, "Don't you care if we drown?" So Jesus gets up, and he says to the storm, "Quiet. Be still." And the sea becomes completely calm. Then he asks his disciples why they are so scared and if they have any faith at all. Like he was frustrated with them. Because even though Jesus said, "Let's go to the other side of the lake," his disciples thought he was going to just let them die.
About 3.5 hours, bud.
Oh. Well, it's 10 a.m. now, so that means you guys can grab one more item from your road trip bags.
And it's my turn to be the king.
Oh, Elijah, it's okay. You were a very good...
Joel died. Everyone does eventually, I suppose.
They are weeper.
more than that, if he does die, will Jesus even care? Will he weep for him as he did for Lazarus? Will he weep for me? I think greater than my fear of death is that of insignificance. Or rather, my default assumption is that my thoughts and passions and loves and the stuff of my being are insignificant. How could the creator of all that is and ever was love my son as he did Lazarus? And could my soul stranded on this blue raft, awash in a sea of stars, ice, and dust, matter enough to him to turn his hand in mercy? Jesus wept for Lazarus. 5 minutes later, he raised Lazarus from the dead.
We always do. It just scares me every time. I just really believe he'll be healed. I know you believe too, just when you act like that, I get all unsure.
I don't know that.
What do you mean?
I just hope that. I don't know.
The temple of God. Was that the cancer?
She was not in the wind. She was not in the earthquake. She was not in the fire. She was here in the gentle whisper.
Picnic at the edge of the world.
So here we are. And the air is emptier without his laugh, and yet our hearts are still full, though with a different drink. And this ride we've been on for so long is silent.
Did he die?
So also the Lord. And so we sit here in this new silence, and long for the music to start again, and for the disc to spin again, even if it means going round and round for many more years. For at least we would be moving, and Joel would be laughing here on Earth, but not only in hell. But in this space, I sense his silence is only because he is drawing his breath. And now we know love and longing, empty and full, all in one moment. And I am grateful that we loved him well, and that we miss him well. And I hope that in the Lord's next breath, he will whisper his love song to you, his beloved, and that you will know him differently and more deeply. But now, we grieve in silence, yet not without his presence.
Look at all of these pancakes. Did you ever see pancakes like this? They're big as me. A big one's is for me. A little one's is for my dog. I always wanted a dog, and now I got one. I even got rebels. I love the bubbles. Do you see a rainbow in a pebble? Come here, Manju. Have another pancake. Manju loves syrup. Me too. Syrup is my favorite part.
That was a good game. Sorry for the yawns throughout the game. It's 1:05 now. It's been about an hour. Sorry for your loss, the Greens. Not that you'll see this, but I'm sorry to the Greens for their loss. Thank you so much if you stuck it in and, like, waited until the end. I'm sorry. Sucks that this little boy died. I mean, sounds amazing. And the pain that they went through, and the fact that they overcame it and pushed through anyways. It's good that you guys got that. So, you know, I hope you guys got as much as you did out of this one as I did. The story is amazing. 4 years in and out of chemo and everything else, whatever they could do, that's horrible. But, you know, they got more time with him, which is what they wanted. So much for watching this video. This was an amazing game. Not game, but story. I hope y'all. Yeah. I'll see you all in the next one. Sorry, this has kind of got me. Mixture of this being sad, also it being 1 in the morning. So, I'll see you in the next one. Bye, guys.